What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you how to export a video using Media Encoder. In this video, you'll learn about exporting with Cue in Premiere Pro, change export settings within Media Encoder, and how to use Media Encoder to convert file formats.
That's good.
Alright guys, so I want to show you how to export using Media Encoder. I want to show you guys how to use the Cue button that you see when you open up those export settings. And I want to explain every way that you can use the tool to its fullest. Okay, so being inside of Premiere, we already know that we can do Control or Command M and bring up those export settings. So we'll just have them load back up. Bada bing. Okay, so we got this up. Now I also want to show you how you can actually set up two videos to export. That's the real scenario you would actually use Cue for Media Encoder. Otherwise, I just hit export and then watch the bar go by. And then it would be complete on my desktop. So I'm gonna hit X on that. And so now I wanna show you guys the project panel real quick. So let me shift my camera, just put it over here. Okay, so in the project panel, if I wanted to export two videos, one, and they're both the same, except the only difference is the music choice. They're both gonna be the same video, so I'm just gonna duplicate it by right-clicking on it and then hitting duplicate for that sequence. And now let's just say I can double click it, open it, and then just replace the music track. So let's say I have two, and I have two music tracks going for the different videos, and I wanna show Jen what she thinks and see which song feels right for her brand. So I wanna export both of those at the same time. So I'm gonna hold shift, and I'm gonna click on both of them, and then I'm gonna right click and go to export media. Now this is gonna bring up a slightly different export window. And we're going to see the export settings right here. And so we've got H.264, the preset is match source high bitrate like we have on the others. Then we got these checkmarked, and then we got checkmarked on all the match source, right? But it doesn't show a preview on the left. And that's because we have two videos selected, so it's not gonna show both previews. But it only gives us the option to queue. So we can't export two videos at the same time inside of Premiere, but we can do it inside of Media Encoder. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete that example that I created because I don't need it. So I'm just going to click on here, and I'm gonna have the sequence highlighted. Let's do Control or Command M, bada bing. And we can do that from the project panel as well. Hold on, let me switch my face over. Okay, so we have this video open, and we also have the queue option here too. So instead of hitting export inside of Premiere, we're gonna hit queue, and it's gonna automatically open Media Encoder. So we're just gonna wait for that to pop open for us. Okay, so it's loading in, it should pop up, and there it is. Okay, so if we wanna change the flavor in here, we can do that as well. Just click this drop down arrow. You can do QuickTime, and I say flavor, I mean codec. It's just the way that I like to describe it. And then what we can do is we can choose from any preset in here. We'll just keep that match source high bitrate because that's the one we like the most. And then we can click on the output file to change how we wanna save it. So I'll just save it to the desktop. Bada bing. Okay, so what's also great about Media Encoder is you can add any video to it and change the file format that it's in. You can compress videos further. If you have a large file that's a minute long and it's QuickTime, it's a .mlv, you can pop it in the Media Encoder and you can export it as an H.264. Let's just say, for example, one of these proxies is a .mlv, okay? So we'll just drop it into Media Encoder. I just dragged it in like that. And there, it loads. So we can change the codec to QuickTime, which is the .mov, change this to ProRes 422HQ, which is the best way to export out of QuickTime for a .mov, and we can change the location. So we can just hit the play button, and it won't export them both at the same time, but it'll do it one by one. So I hope that all makes sense, guys. I know exporting can be a little complicated, but everything that I've explained to you will export your video totally perfectly fine, and it'll be amazing. So I want to start exporting as soon as possible, but first I want to explain a couple things just so you guys are set up for more success on YouTube or Instagram or even in Hollywood making a movie. So with that, I'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, so this tutorial is from a full course on Adobe Premiere Pro. Go to ParEdits.com/PremierePro or click the link in the description down below.